Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October the 12th of 2020, well, it is titled Descending Toward Asteroid Bennu. So what do we see here? Well, this is a set of images put together into a video clip that'll run about 30 seconds long when we play it. And we're looking at the asteroid known as Bennu, and this is currently being explored by the OSIRIS-REx spacecraft. And in fact, it's been there for a year and a half and has put together all of the images that make up the video clip that we see. So let's go ahead and play the video and see what we have here. And as you start playing it, you'll see a very fast rotating asteroid, much, much faster than it actually rotates. And then it will slow down and we'll be able to see some detail on it and that it's a very rocky, rugged surface. And it will rotate much slower and slowly slow down. And then eventually we will zoom in on one specific section to take a look at here. And you can see a very large object here, probably something about the size of a house here. Now you have to take into account that this is a much smaller object than we're used to looking at on Earth. The whole asteroid is only about half a kilometer in size. So much smaller than anything we see here on Earth in terms of a planet sized object. And we can see that it's distorted into a weird shape and that it's almost a diamond shape. And that's because its gravity isn't sufficiently strong to pull itself into a sphere, much as things like our Earth and our moon are able to do. So we see very irregular objects. And in fact, when you look at the mountains on this compared to what we'd see with the mountains on Earth, relative to the size of the object, they are much, much larger. And again, that is because of the lack of gravitational force, because the gravity is so much smaller because of a much lower mass of the object. Now, in just another week or so, next week, the OSIRIS-REx is going to land briefly or touch down on the asteroid to collect a sample and bring a sample of Bennu back to Earth. Now, it will take several years to get back. It's not expected to return until 2023. But it will give us a chance to study up close a piece of an asteroid here in the laboratory. So a chance to take a small piece of this asteroid, bring it back here and study it. And while it's one thing to study objects out in space, it's also a different thing to be able to study them here on Earth, because there is far more testing that we can do and experimentation that we can do. And we have access, of course, to far more equipment and machinery than we can send to the asteroid itself. So in a way, being able to do this is a great way to be able to better understand and better understand the asteroids. Now, why is that so important? Well, asteroids are kind of the building blocks of the planets in the solar system. And it was objects like this that combined together billions of years ago that actually made the Earth. So a chance to look at some of these objects and to see sort of the building blocks of things that eventually became planets, like the terrestrial planets such as Earth. So that was our picture of the day for October the 12th of 2020. It was titled Descending Toward Asteroid Bennu. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be opposing Mars. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.